This video is called Area of the Shaded Region 2. There's a couple different ways to approach this problem, and I know, you know, some students kind of tend to gravitate towards one way while many students gravitate towards another. So as the teacher who's making these videos, I'm going to show you both ways. Again, you don't have to understand both ways, but I ask that you watch both ways, and so you can kind of decide for yourself what works better for you. Some students would like to do this problem like the previous video, where if you dropped lines down here, you could do the area of the whole thing. Ooh, that got messy. Sorry, I don't know why it's writing like that. You could do the area of the whole thing, which is a big rectangle, minus the area of the white parts. And that's a really good way to do it. You'll have your two parts. It's really easy to see the area of the whole thing. We've got 8. And 8 is a base, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So 8 times 4 would be 32 would be the area of the whole thing, and then minus the area of the white parts, we would have the area of these to be 4 and 4. So we'd have 32 minus 8, which would give us an area of 24 units squared. So if you can really picture the rectangle being a piece of construction paper with those two squares cut out, area of the whole minus the area of the white is a great way to go. Other students said, well, Mrs. Milton, isn't this kind of like the problems we did at the beginning of the note sheet, where you could draw an imaginary line here, an imaginary line here, and find the area of all three shapes and add them up? You certainly could. Along the top, it looks like it is an 8 by 1. 8 times 1 is 8. The bottom is also an 8 by 1. 8 times 1 is 8. And then in the middle, if this is 2, and this is 2, that adds up to 4, that makes the missing part 4, because this bottom has to add up to 8, because it matches with my top piece. 4 times 2 is 8. So if you did 8 plus 8 plus 8, you'd also get 24 units squared. Okay? So I think, looking at this, there's two different approaches to this problem, and we've dealt with both approaches in this lesson. So it really is up to you to decide which way you want to solve this. Maybe your teacher has a preference. You'll have to kind of ask him or her. Personally, this is Mrs. Milton. I like both ways. As long as you can show your work so I can see your thinking, I would accept either method. You choose what you like the best and go with it. All right? So it's time to work on your check-in quiz. Please make a solid effort. Take your time. Answer the questions really the best you can. Don't just fly through it. And we will work on all of this more in class tomorrow. Thanks. Have a good night.